हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम प्रोफेसर मल्लिकार्जुन आउटे। टुडेज पॉइंट ऑफ डिस्कशन इज प्रॉब्लम्स ऑन मैक्सिमम पावर ट्रांसमिशन कैपेसिटी ऑफ द गियर, और इट इज आल्सो नोन एज डिजाइन फॉर मैक्सिमम पावर ट्रांसमिशन कैपेसिटी। सो व्हेनेवर द वर्ड कम इन अ प्रॉब्लम दैट मैक्सिमम पावर ट्रांसमिशन कैपेसिटी, एट दैट टाइम वी हैव टू यूज और वी हैव टू राइट दिस इक्वेशन, or we have to use this equation, PT is equal to PD is equal to SW by 2. So what is this equation? If you want to see how this equation has been come, so you just go through my lecture of derivation for maximum power transmission capacity. Okay, so I will just read the problem. A pair of spur gear with 20 degree full depth involute teeth consist of 20 teeth pinion meshing with 41 teeth gear. The module is 2 mm, the face width is 20 mm, the gears are machined to meet the specification of grade 8 and heat treated to a surface hardness of 250 bhm. And determine the optimum speed for maximum power transmission capacity. So I have underlined the word maximum power transmission capacity, means it is a problem for maximum power transmission capacity. And the second objective is, we have to find out the maximum power transmitted by the gears at the optimum speed. So here we have to calculate the optimum speed, and using that optimum speed we have to calculate the maximum power transmitted by the gears. And for grade 8, the error is given as 16 plus 1.25 into m plus 0.25 into bracket square root of d. The value will be in terms of microns, and here the material has not been specified, so I am assuming both the gears are made up of steel. Pinion as well as gear are made up of steel. Okay, you can go for other assumption also. You can assume both the gears are made up of cast iron, or one is made up of steel, other is made up of cast iron. But I am assuming the initial condition where both the gears are made up of steel. I will just write down the given content here. Alpha is a 20 degree, then ZP, number of teeth on the pinion 20, number of teeth on the gear 41, module is 2 mm, B is 20 mm, face width, grade is 8, hardness number is equal to 250, and for grade 8, this is the value of error. And both gears are of steel. Both gears are of steel. Okay. So here, how the problem or flow of the problem will be. So I will just show you here how will be the flow of problem, and based on that we will solve the problem. So here it has been mentioned that for maximum power transmission capacity, this is the general equation, or this is the basic equation, PT is equal to PD is equal to SW by T. This is the equation we have derived for maximum power transmission capacity. So here I will first calculate VS strength, right? So I will calculate VS strength, and if you divide VS strength by 2, you will be getting the value for PD. And both are made up of steel, that's why you have to use this equation. And in this equation, all the terms are known, error, etc. we can calculate. Only unknown parameter is NP, so I will be getting the value for NP. That is nothing but optimum speed for maximum power transmission capacity. We will get our first objective. And in second objective, I have to find out the power. So again, for finding out the value of power, torque is required, and torque can be calculated by PT. So PT is given by SW by 2, which is equal to PT, and we will get PT. And torque, PT into D dash P by 2, and power is equal to 2 pi NP MT divided by 16 to 10 dash to 6. And this NP we have calculated here, same value I am going to use here. So from that we are going to get the value for power. This is how the flow of problem will be. And now we will start the problem. Okay, so I will first write down the equation for maximum. I'm just writing down the equation for maximum power transmission I can use the equation PT is equal to PD is equal to SW/2. And just now we have discussed the flow of the problem. So I will first find out the wear strength. Therefore, SW is the wear strength, which is given by the equation BQ D dash P into K. I will first find out the value for Q. Q is equal to 2 into ZG divided by ZG plus ZP. So 2 into number of teeth on the gear are 41 divided by 41 plus number of teeth on the pinion are 20. Therefore Q is equal to, so I can calculate now value of Q. I have fixed the calci on precision of up to 3 decimals. So 2 into 41 divided by 41 plus 20 is nothing but 60. So Q is equal to 1.367 is the value for Q. Right? Now what we will do, we will calculate the value for pitch circle diameter of pinion. D dash P is equal to M into ZP. Therefore D dash P is equal to M. The module is equal to 2 mm and number of teeth on the pinion is equal to 20. Therefore D dash P is equal to 40 mm. Right? We got the value for pitch circle diameter of pinion. Then K is equal to 0.16 into BHN by 100 bracket square. From this equation I can calculate the value of K. So 0.16 BHN, it is given as 250 divided by 100 and its square. So K can be calculated as 2.5 square into 0.16. So K is equal to 1. So I have got all the inputs, so I can calculate the wear strength. Therefore SW is equal to BQ D dash P into K. So B is equal to 20 mm, Q is equal to 1.367, D dash P is equal to 40 and K is equal to 1. So I have written all the terms. I will just calculate the wear strength now. 20 into 1.367 into 40 into 1. So I will get the wear strength as 1093.6 newton. So now I got the wear strength. So I will just write down the values for PT and PD, because wear strength divided by 2. So I will be getting PD as well as PT. Okay. So I will do the same thing. So here SW/2 is equal to PT is equal to PD. Therefore it is PT which is equal to PD, which is equal to 10, PT is equal to PD is equal to SW/2, means 1093.6 divided by 2. So PT is equal to PD is equal to 1093.6 divided by 2. So I will calculate, it is equal to 546.8 newton. So PT is equal to PD, that is equal to 546.8 newton. Right? Now I want to find out first the RPM, because in the problem what they have said, find first the RPM here, plus first find NP RPM and second we have to find out the power. Okay, so we will first find out the RPM. So finding out first RPM, that is nothing but the optimum speed. Okay. So I am knowing PD, so I will write down the equation for PD because both the gears are made up of steel, that I have assumed. So I will say for steel pinion and gear, I will write like this, PD is equal to E NP ZP B R1 R2 divided by 2530 in square root R1 square plus R2 square. So here, first I have to calculate the error for pinion, then I will calculate the error for gear, and after that we will add both the errors. So I will first start with the pinion. So for pinion, EP is equal to, for pinion EP is equal to, for grade 8 they have given the values here, 16 plus 1.25. So I will write 16 plus 1.25 into bracket M plus 0.25. Here I will be writing square root of D dash P because I am finding it for pinion. The answer will be in terms of microns. Therefore, EP is equal to 16 plus 1.25, the value of module is 2, plus 0.25. What is now pitch circle diameter of pinion? Pitch circle diameter of pinion is nothing but what? The product of module into number of teeth. So we can calculate pitch circle diameter of pinion here. I can calculate D dash P is equal to M into ZP. So M is 2 and ZP is equal to 20. Therefore, I can write D dash P is equal to 40 mm. I will write here 40. The answer will be in terms of microns. We will calculate the terms. Now here I will start with square root of 40 into 0.25 plus 2 into 1.25 plus 16. So I got the error for pinion as 20.476 microns. Now I have done it for pinion. I will do it for gear. For gear. Okay, so first I will calculate the pitch circle diameter of gear. So that is nothing but here D dash G is equal to M into ZG. So module is 2. The number of teeth on the gear are 41. So 2 into 41. So D dash G is equal to 82 mm. Right, now I will calculate the error. Error for gear is equal to, again for grade 8 the value has been given in the problem, 16 plus 1.25 to M plus 0.25. so either other than writing D dash P, I will write D dash G, means pitch circle diameter of gear, and the answer will be in terms of microns. Now I will calculate error for gear, 16 plus 1.25, the module is equal to 2, 0.25, and pitch circle diameter of gear, just now we have calculated that as 82 mm. Okay, so I will do the calculation here, square root of 82. Into 0.25 plus 2 into 1.25 plus 16. So I got the value for error of gear as 21.33 microns. So we will calculate the total error now. therefore E is equal to EP plus EG, that is equal to 20.476 plus 21.33, so the error is equal to 41.806 microns, or I will write like this, error is equal to 41.806 into 10 raised to minus 3 mm. This is the value of what? Total error for pinion as well as gear in terms of millimeter. Okay. So we have calculated first value of error. Now we are knowing NP, ZP. Thing is that we should calculate now R1 and R2. Okay. So here we have to calculate R1 and R2. So now I will say R1 is nothing but pitch circle diameter of pinion divided by 2. And pitch circle diameter of pinion is 40. So it is 40 divided by 2, which is equal to 20 mm. And similarly, R2 is nothing but pitch circle diameter of gear divided by 2. Pitch circle diameter of gear is 82 mm. So 82 divided by 2 is equal to 41 mm. That is the value for what? R1 and R2. So here we have calculated error. We are knowing PD, ZP, B, R1, R2 we are having. So only thing is that we have to calculate NP now. That will be our first objective. So now I am rewriting the equation. PD is equal to E, NP, ZP, B, R1, R2 divided by 2530 in square root R1 square plus R2 square. So simply I will write these values. E, error. What is the error? 41.806 into 10 raised to minus 3. So I am writing that value. Error is 41.806 into 10 raised to minus 3 E. NP, RPM of pinion, that we have to calculate. ZP is 20. B is the face width, which is given as 20 mm, into R1. R1 is 20 and R2 is 41. So R1 is 20 and R2 is 41. So these are the values at the numerator, divided by 2530 in square root R1 square plus R2 square. So it is 20 square plus 41 square. So therefore PD is equal to, we will calculate this. First I will start, I have to keep this value of PD which is there on the left hand side. We have calculated the value of PD as 546.8 Newton. So this value will be here. 546.8 is equal to, right? So again same, that value will be on the left hand side, 546.8. So we have to calculate the value for NP. I will calculate the denominator first. 546.8, that is equal to, denominator will be here, 20 square plus 41 square, square root has to be multiplied by 2530. So I got the denominator as 115413.487. Now we will calculate for the numerator. Here it is 41.806 into 10 raised to minus 3, this is the value for error, NP we have to calculate, into 20, right? 20 nothing but number of teeth, on the pinion into face width, which is also equal to 20. Then we are finding out the value of R1. R1 is also equal to 20, and R2 is equal to 41. So we got the answer 13712.368 into NP. So we will cross multiply this and divide by this term. Okay, so I will type 546.8 multiplied by 115413.487 divided by this answer. So I got the RPM of pinion as 4602.275 is the RPM of pinion. So this is our answer for the first objective. We have calculated the optimum speed for finding out optimum speed based on the maximum power transmission capacity, means PT is equal to PD is equal to SW by 2. So we have calculated the first one. Now what is our second objective? Second objective is to find out the power transmitted or maximum power transmitted by gears at optimum speed. So we are finding out the value of power. What is required? Torque is required, and for finding out the value of torque, PT is required. So what is PT? We know that PT is equal to PD is equal to 546.8. So I will write here, PT is equal to 546.8 Newton, right? And I will calculate torque. So now torque MT is equal to PT into D dash P divided by 2. So 546.8 into pitch circle diameter of pinion is 40. So it is 546.8 into 20. 40 by 2 is 20. So torque I am going to get as 10936 Newton mm. This is the value of what? Torque. Now from torque we can calculate power. So now the last element is calculation of power. Power is given by 2 pi np mt divided by 60 into 10 raised to 6 2 pi into RPM of pinion. We have just calculated the value of pinion is 4602.275 is the RPM of pinion into the value of torque, which is 10936. Right, this value divided by 60 into 10 raised to 6. Okay, so I will calculate this. I do already value 10936 into 2 pi into 4602.275. divided by 60 into 10 raised to 6. Okay, so I will just go for calculation one more time. 2 pi into 4602.275 into 10936 divided by 60 into 10 raised to 6. See here, the value I got is 5.271 kilowatt or
I can write like this, P is equal to, power is equal to 5.271 kilovolt. So this is nothing but the second objective, that we have calculated the value of maximum power transmitted by the gear at optimum speed, means this value of NP which we have calculated, that value we have used here as the NP. So this is nothing but the problem on maximum power transmission capacity, in which the main criteria is, whenever the term is like this mentioned in the problem, maximum power transmission capacity, you have to use this equation, PT is equal to PD is equal to SWI2, and based on this you have to adjust your terms accordingly, and you have to find out what the question has been asked in the exam. Okay, thank you.